Look, we're all getting older. There's no stopping that, and actually, I don't prefer to stop it. But as we get older, we can absolutely age gracefully. So today, I'm sharing 16 tips to help you and me age gracefully. Hello ladies, welcome to today's video. It's a little different than some of the most recent videos I've shot. I want to just kind of slow down a little bit and just have a heart-to-heart talk. You know, the truth is, as I have been doing this for the last year and been blogging for the last, I guess, 3 or 4 years now, and I talk a lot about fashion and beauty and fitness, and it's real easy to get caught up in what other influencers are doing and just what's going on in the stores and with the brands. And, you know, I get the catalogs like you do with all the fashions. And I want to look pretty. I want to look young. I want to look like I did when I was 30. And I don't. And just, you know, I didn't start doing this until I was, what, 55? So that's kind of late in you know, age. And I've aged a lot just in the last 3 years. When I go back and look at my earlier photos from when I first started blogging, it's just crazy to me how much I feel like I've aged in just 3 years or 4 years. So the truth is, we're getting older, and there are those telltale signs, and there are, sure, there are procedures and there are things I could do about it. And maybe you've done some of those, and I think that's great. I have no qualms with any kinds of procedures that women might have. That's not the route I'm choosing to go, and I'm going to get older and I'm going to look older, and that's just the way it is. But I do think that we can age gracefully. I feel like we can look our age and still look youthful. And by that, I mean we can look vibrant and we can glow and we can look like we are involved in life and we're engaged and we still have something to offer. And so that's my goal, is simply to be my best, right? And I thought that might be your goal too. If it's not, I encourage you to think about that, because truthfully, as I've pointed out before here on this channel, when we try to look younger, we kind of end up just looking foolish, I think. It doesn't fit, it doesn't work, because I think most people can tell about how old we are. And so if we raid our granddaughter's closet, or we shop in the same place she does, or we try to wear all the things that the 20-something bloggers and YouTubers are showing, then somehow it looks disingenuous. It doesn't add up. And so I'm just done with trying to look young, and instead I'm all about aging gracefully, aging well, aging beautifully, so that I look my age, but I just still look my best. So I'm gonna give you 16 tips. I'm trying to keep this under 16 minutes. We'll see how fast we can do this. And first of all, I think a graceful woman looks, she's fluid, right, in her movements. She is still able to just be fluid, and she's able to be mobile, and she's able to get around and do things and engage in life. And you know what? Before I go any further though, let me say to you, I know that some of you are not very mobile. Some of you have limitations. Some of you have had things to happen over the course of your life that have truly slowed you down physically. And I want you to know that I still believe that you can age gracefully, and you can still absolutely look graceful and be graceful. But for those of us who still are, perhaps we're younger, perhaps we still have more of our health intact, we need to work to keep it that way. So let me give you 4 tips in that area. First of all, we have got to keep moving. And that may mean a daily morning walk. That may mean a daily evening walk. It may mean 3 or 4 times a week you get out and walk. I definitely think it means when we drive to the store, we park away from the store instead of up close to it. And we get out of that car and we walk through the parking lot, we walk through the store, we move as much as we can. I just encourage you to keep moving. The more we move, the more graceful we are going to be, because we're going to stay more agile, we're going to stay more mobile, we're going to stay more fluid. But the second thing we have to do is sort of like that, and that is we have got to get serious about weight training, about weightlifting, about lifting those weights. And by that, I don't mean that you just go pick up those same 3 pounders or 2 pounders or even 5 pounders that you've been lifting for the last 10 years and do the same exercises. I was doing that, ladies, and let me tell you something, that didn't cut it. Not until I started lifting heavier and more frequently and in more of a variation did it really begin to change things. And one of the things that happens as we get older is we absolutely do lose muscle mass, but we can stop that. We can completely change that. And one of the ways to do that is to build muscle, and it's with weightlifting. And so I encourage you to do what it takes. Now, I'm in the Faster Way to Fat Loss. I would be glad to share with you more about that. I'll give you some links below to some of the posts I've written at my blog about Faster Way. I'm a full believer in it. It really has changed my life. But just find a way to get serious about weightlifting. It can make a world of difference. The third thing that we can do to age more gracefully is change our diet as needed. Oh my goodness, I hate that because I still like to eat, as I say, like a fifth grader. And I'm not a fifth grader. I'm not even a 50-year-old. I'm 57 years old, and I've had to come to a reckoning with the fact that I have got to change the way I eat, because as we get older, we do develop that middle tire around our waist. We begin to put on weight in places that are quite dangerous, honestly. That weight around our gut indicates that there is perhaps also fat around our heart. That's just not a good thing. And so for me, it has meant you eating less refined sugars and refined starches and more vegetables. It has meant eating less processed foods and more lean protein. It has meant drinking more water and less wine. You know, I've got to change the way I eat, and I've gotten serious about it. And I encourage you to do that too if you want to age gracefully. And number four is simply something I am so terrible about, but that is, I think we need to take time every day to stretch a little bit. You know, like I said, I think we look more graceful when we're more fluid. And if we will just take the time every day to just really stretch out, or perhaps to do some yoga or Pilates, that could really help with our flexibility, our fluidity, our posture, all of those things that can really translate as beauty. Another thing that I know about graceful women is they seem to know their style and to wear it well. And they look attractive. They look like they have put some effort into their appearance, but not too much effort. They're not overdoing it. So my first tip in the area of fashion is to learn to work with a smaller but more elevated wardrobe. You know, last week I did a video, a capsule wardrobe for fall, and I mentioned that I don't do that. I don't actually use a capsule wardrobe because as a blogger, as an influencer, as a YouTuber, I have a whole lot more clothes than that. But I would love the opportunity to really work with that kind of a wardrobe, because I think that wardrobe, that smaller wardrobe, gives you the opportunity to really focus on quality instead of quantity. And here's what I've noticed. As we get older, I think it is all the more important that our garments be as high a quality as we possibly can afford. Now, I'm not talking about breaking the bank on your clothes. I'm just saying, you know, ladies, it's time to stop buying so many clothes and instead buy a few pieces each season that really contribute some value to a smaller wardrobe that mixes and matches beautifully and that will really make us look a little bit more sophisticated and more graceful. To do that, you're really going to, number two in this area, you're going to have to define your style and then just really stick with it. I've got some tools at my blog. I have a little quiz that's just really kind of for fun, but I think it does help us to define our personal style aesthetic. And the way I figure it, there are about 6 or 7 different personal style aesthetics in general, but you could have like a combination too. So you could be anything from romantic to natural, to rebellious and a little edgy, or very classic and elegant. So whatever your style is, I don't think we need to pigeonhole ourselves in order to age gracefully. I have seen older women with every kind of style out there. I know some who dress beautifully and look so put together, although, but they, unlike me, they wear a lot of color and just a lot of juxtaposition and just like really out there. And I think they look great. So it's not a matter of pigeonholing you into one particular style and saying you have to wear that all the time, but it's you do you, but go for it and do it well. And that way you can wear that wardrobe with confidence and you can really feel authentic every time you show up. My next tip in fashion is simply to build a wardrobe that is both fashionable and functional and comfortable. You know, ladies, at our age, we just need to be done with those pieces, those garments that you put on and you feel so uncomfortable that you cannot even be yourself all day. And you just feel out of sorts and you feel discombobulated when you wear them. Let's just be done with that. Choose a wardrobe that is both fashionable but also oh so comfortable for you. And then my last tip as far as fashion is to learn to accessorize our outfits tastefully and beautifully. I just go back to the old saying of, you know, get dressed and then look in the mirror and then take one thing off. I think it is so much more important as we've gotten older to do that. I mean, even today, let's see, I was trying to feel, do I have a necklace on? I put these big earrings on and I have on a silk blouse and I put on a necklace and I just thought, you know what, that's just too much. And so I took it off. And I don't know, you may or may not like that look, but for me, I've just decided as I've gotten older that paired back, there's just something to be said for that. Another thing I know about graceful women is that they really do look beautiful. I mean, there's just something about them that glows, right? They have definitely lost some of their youthfulness perhaps, but they still glow. They still have a smile on their face. So I do have four beauty tips for you too. And the first one is we have got to invest in a good skincare regimen. You know, I think when we were younger, it was probably sufficient just to cleanse our face. And then as we got a little older, we added moisturizing. And then as we got a little older, we added a nighttime moisturizer. But at our age, I think most of us need a little bit more help than that. And there are some good serums out there that can really do a little bit more. There are eye serums, there are full face serums, there are even some things for our lips and for our hands. Those things are so important. A couple weeks ago or so, I did a video with L'Oreal, and they do have a great midnight serum that I really can highly recommend. I just think it's really necessary that we nail down our skincare. My next tip as far as beauty is to get a modern hairstyle and then really learn how to do your hair that way, you know. And what's modern? What do I mean by modern? Well, what's really trending right now and what really looks youthful, not young necessarily, but youthful, is a very relaxed hairstyle. So whatever your hair does, let it do that a little bit naturally and then just give it a little bit of help. So my hair is naturally kind of wavy, so sometimes I do wear it wavy like you see here, and other times I straighten it and let it go like this. But the less fuss and muss, the better these days. But we do want to look like we've put a little effort in, keep our hair healthy and clean, of course, and just well taken care of. But let's just relax a little bit with our hairstyle. The next tip is one I really do struggle with, and that is to have well manicured hands and nails. And I struggle with it because I don't know about you, but as I've gotten older, my nails have just gotten even more brittle and they break easily. So I keep my nails pretty short, but I really do try to keep them polished or at least cleanly, you know, filed down and straight and about all the same length. I think it's so important because one of the things I've learned as we've gotten older is I've noticed when I meet other people that I notice their hands, and I've learned as a rule that we notice each other's hands. We think nobody sees our hands because I guess we don't look at them a lot, but people do notice our hands. So I think it's a good idea to work at keeping our nails clean and manicured and also lotioning up. Of course, it's also important just to learn how to apply makeup. Now, I say that, and probably most of us have been wearing makeup since we were 16, but the truth is that the way we did our makeup back when we were 16, not only is it probably out of style, but it just doesn't work for us anymore. I mean, I have these little wrinkles around my mouth. I have wrinkles between my forehead. My eyebrows have gotten even more scant than they were before. I mean, my coloring has changed. I mean, my goodness, everything's just changed. So I've noticed that as I've gotten older, I have to do my makeup differently. I do define my eyebrows, whereas once I didn't do that. I don't wear as much eyeliner. I really don't even wear any eyeliner for the most part. Sometimes I'll use a little powder around the lid of my eye. I kind of focus more on eyelashes, and I try to add the color of youthfulness to my face. So I do add some color on my cheeks and just some really neutral tones around my eyes. We have to learn how to do it all over again, y'all. Another thing I've noticed about graceful women is they're engaged with the world around them. You know, I would say that the women to me who don't appear to have aged very gracefully are actually kind of living in the past, and they live with the mindset of, oh, woe is me, I wish for the good old days. And I get that because I kind of wish for the good old days too, but I really think that the graceful women I see who are older are ones who are living in this day and age. You know, even in the Bible, it tells us that David did well in his generation. He served in his generation, King David did. And I want to be a woman who lives well in the generation that God has put me in. The first tip I have in this area is to get some younger friends. I remember when I was in my 20s and 30s, I had some older friends and I loved those relationships. My daughter right now, she has an older woman who's actually my age, but she's her mentor in a little cohort of women, and she loves that. So, you know, we could reach out to some young women, whether it be your daughters and daughter-in-laws, that's a given, but go beyond that. Befriend a neighbor who's younger than you, or a friend at church. Befriend someone who maybe wants a mentor, someone like my daughter did, or maybe just get to know, you know, some young women through a multi-generational club or organization that you could join, like a book club or a knitting club. Make an effort to build some friendships with some younger women. Number two is to keep learning. Now, that's the kind of tip that I could give, and we could go, oh yeah, I do that. Wait a minute, let's really think about this. This is not just boiled down to reading a good book every now and then. I encourage you to really stretch yourself. Maybe learn a new language. Maybe learn how to play a new instrument. Maybe if you don't sew, learn to sew. If you don't knit, learn to knit. Learn something really, really new. In fact, did you know that learning something new is one of the best ways to keep your brain sharp? My third tip is, if you want to be a graceful woman, then you've got to be full of grace and you've got to be giving some. I encourage us to give some grace to people every day. Everybody around us needs some grace, especially in the last year or two that we've lived here. We really need to be giving grace. We're all dealing with things very differently and doing the best we can. And I just think we need to give some grace. But that's one of those tips, once again, that I could give it and you could say, oh yeah, I do that. And I'm prone to do that too. But you know what, ladies, let's get really serious about this. Let's make it a goal every day at the end of the day to say, who did I give a little grace to? You know, we could give a little grace to our spouse, give a little grace to your coworkers, give a little grace to the person who's in front of you in the grocery store line who's going so, so slow. Give a little grace to people at church. Give a little grace to the neighbor who does not keep their yard as tidy as you do. Give a little grace. And then my final tip is one that I got from my parents because they have truly aged gracefully, and that is to keep serving. If there's one thing my parents have done right, and actually they have done just about everything on this list, is they serve, and they're in their 80s, but they serve beautifully. I have found that graceful women are those who are not self-consumed and self-focused, but instead they're focused on other people. And as we serve, when we make intentional efforts, we really like plan it on our calendar. We get in touch with a nonprofit organization or our church and say, what can I do? And then we put it on our calendar, we go do it. We actually put some feet to this well intentions and we serve somebody. It just takes our focus off of ourselves. And you know what else it does? It gives us a little joy. And I have noticed that graceful women are joyful women. Thank you so much for joining me for today's video. I hope it was encouraging for you because it was convicting for me. And if you really enjoyed it, would you please share it on Facebook? Or you could even copy the link through the little share tab below and send it to somebody in an email. Because I think this is one of those topics that we need to share with everybody, not just necessarily women who enjoy fashion and beauty, but everybody, even our spouse, our sister, our brother-in-law, everybody. Share this video as much as you can. Thanks so much, ladies. I'll see you next week.